Hello friends, this is going to be a requested video on the desserts. Yahya had asked me to make it, and on Indus Plains I've already made a video. Yahya, please go and check that out. Okay, so beginning with, you know, the desert areas of Pakistan. Now let's quickly understand that in Pakistan there are around three deserts, three most important deserts, 1, 2, and 3. The first one is the Kharan Desert, which is in Balochistan, the Thar Desert in Punjab, and the Thar or the Thar Parkar Desert in Sindh. Now moving on to the map of Pakistan to understand the location of these deserts. So if you look at the map of Pakistan, you see that Kharan Desert is located in the province of Balochistan, the Thar Desert is in Sindh, and the Thar Desert is in Punjab. Now Thar is in between two rivers, that is the Indus River and the Jhelum River. An area between the two rivers is called as Doab. The name of that particular Doab is Sindh Sagar Doab. Okay, so Thar is divided into three main deserts, that is Cholistan, Nara, and Thar Parkar. You got to remember all these names, and whenever you are given, you know, such a map where these areas are marked, you should be able to identify that whether it's the Kharan, Thal, or the Thar Desert, because you get such questions in your papers. Now moving on to the features of the desert area. Now the main feature of a desert area is winds. You know, they constantly keep blowing, and they are responsible for the change in the landscape. The most dominant feature that's visible there is the rolling sand dunes. Then there's always this weathering of rocks. Weathering of rocks means the breakage, the wear and tear of rocks because of the action of the wind. Then there's lack of vegetation, and because of lack of vegetation you mostly see there bare rocks. And you know, the water table there in the deserts is usually low because of the scanty rainfall, unlike the other areas of Pakistan, the plain areas of Pakistan. Now moving on to the sand dunes. What are the sand dunes? Now whenever the winds blow in a desert and they have to face an obstacle, an obstruction, you know, the winds carry with them a lot of sand. They start depositing that sand on the windward side, okay? Not on the slip side. The other side is called as a slip side. So they deposit the sand on the windward side and create a ridge or a mound-like structure, which is called as a sand dune. Now the life of the people of living in the desert. Our lives are affected by our environment. There is no doubt about it. So you can imagine how the lives of, you know, people living in the deserts might be. So there are bare rocks. There are holes in the rocks. You know, cutting roads through those areas is very difficult. Cultivation is not possible. Why? Because of lack of rainfall. You cannot even, you know, dig a well because the water table is too low. Now however, you know, some parts of the desert, you know, are very important in the sense that, you know, they are rich in mineral resources. What sort of mineral resources? They, especially, you know, the southern, southeastern part of the Thar Desert is rich in oil, mineral oil, and you know, which was discovered, mineral oil and gas was discovered in this area, so that is why it has become important. Whereas if you look at you know, the Indus River, has a Sakar Barrage, and that Sakar Barrage, you know, the canals that emanate from the Sakar Barrage, they provide water to the Thar Desert. And because of that water, you know, most of that area or Thar Desert has been converted into a farmland. Now, talking about the relief of the Thar Desert, you can mostly understand because we have already discussed what are the main features. Obviously, sand plains. Sand plains, or, you know, sand patties or plain areas in the desert, and undulating plains as well. Undulating means the rise and fall. If you have visited the deserts, you must have seen, you know, the rise and falling of that landscape. That's the undulating plain. Sand dunes is another dominant feature. What is a sand dune? It's a hill, a small mound, or a ridge. Now in between these sand dunes, you know, there is a valley or that V-shaped structure, which is a wide interdunal valley. Now this valley is important. Why? Because it's rich in silt and clay. So if there is proper provision of water to that area, you know, that area can be used for cultivation of crops. Now, usually, you know, there are barren rocks, no vegetation, no trees. Then there's lack of water, because of which, you know, mostly those rocks, you know, they start to crack. And rolling sand hills is another main feature of the desert area. So with this, we conclude. I hope this video was beneficial. Yeah, a big thumbs up for your exam. Do well. And for those of you know, who haven't subscribed as yet, please do subscribe to my channel. If you like my videos, give me a thumbs up and also share it with your friends. So till my next video, I'm Nida Umar signing off. Take care of yourselves and also of your loved ones. Bye bye.